With low temperatures ranging from the low 30s in the outlying suburbs to the upper 30s in downtown Baltimore. Partly cloudy skies on Friday with temperatures in the upper 50s to around 60. On Saturday, it'll become mostly cloudy with a chance for a shower in the afternoon and evening. Saturday's high 64. Some rain Saturday night, ending early Sunday morning, then cloudy. Sunday's high 54. I'm meteorologist Tom Tasselmeyer on WBAL News Radio 1090 at FM 101.5.
48 degrees, 706 here on TV Hill. Hot Stove Baseball's next, live from Mother's North in Timonium on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Now, live from Mother's Grill in Timonium, this is the Orioles Hot Stove Show on WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
One final show from Mother's North in Timonium. We welcome you to Orioles Hot Stove, presented by PBI Office Furniture and Jose Cuervo Tradicional Tequila. Jeff Arnold with you. We have Rabbi Reese Levin with us. He's going to miss the free food of the times that we're here every Thursday night. Brett Hollander is on assignment, as he said last week, so I'm joined by my buddy from MassinSports.com and Steve Molesky. And Steve, you're joining us after a very exciting last week for the Orioles. It actually occurred last Thursday, but it occurred about 30 minutes after we got off the air. Corbin Burnes acquired in a trade with the Milwaukee Brewers for Joey Ortiz, DL Hall, and a competitive balance pick. And for Mike Elias, he finally got his man.
A big trade, and I think a big addition and moment for our team. Corbin Burnes is exactly what we needed. We were in a dogged pursuit of him the entire offseason. Obviously, there were other starting pitchers that we pursued, but it's hard to have somebody higher than Corbin Burnes on your wish list. And it's a tremendous impact. This is something that we and the Brewers talked about. I think it was a great trade for both sides.
It certainly was. And Corbin Burnes, last 4 years, he's finished 6th, 1st, 7th, and 8th in Cy Young voting, winning the award a couple years ago, 3-time All-Star each of the last 3 years. Steve, it's not often that you can trade for somebody who is an ace. But for the Orioles, who are trying to upgrade their pitching staff, and this was at the top of their priority list, they found a way to get it done.
Well, as Mike Elias said, the dogged pursuit, because a lot of the media and a lot of the speculation was focusing so much on Dylan Cease, and who knows, he still may be traded to somebody over the next few months. But the patience, I think, the Orioles front office showed to let this play out to when they could pull the trigger on a move that they realized that they gave up two really good players who may go on to have really good careers. But this was about 2024, a team that won 101 games that might now be the best team in the American League and one of the best in baseball. They finished last year that, and now they add an ace pitcher. They've been trying to get an ace for a long time in these parts, Jeff. Mike Mussina, it's been a long time since they had a pitcher of that caliber, but now you bump everybody back down. That makes the bullpen deeper. That helps the offense when your pitching gets better. He could mentor some of these young guys, so it helps in so many ways.
We're going to get to this a little bit later on in the broadcast, just where the Orioles' rotation now stacks among some of the best ones in the American League. You had an article about this earlier today. Meanwhile, for Corbin Burnes, this is a really cool thing because you have won a Cy Young, but you are trying to win a World Series. And this weekend, he talked about joining a new team.
Yeah, so I've made one start there and it went well, so that's always good. But yeah, obviously the field plays a little different now than it had in years past. But more importantly, I think it's the guys that are behind you. You got a lot of good young defenders behind you, guys that are eager to play, guys that are hungry to go out and win. So it's an exciting team. You know, if I'm going out there doing my job, those guys are going out there doing their job. It's going to create a lot of success and in a division that's obviously a lot of good baseball teams. You know, they won the division last year. And I see no reason why we can't go out there and win the division again this year.
Yeah, and Corbin Burnes would probably be a big part of that. And the thing that you love about Burnes, in each of the last 2 years, he's been right around 200 innings pitched. So not only is he pitching at a very high level, but he can pitch a large volume of innings, which was another thing that you were looking for.
Jeff, here's a guy who led his league in ERA in 2021 when he won the Cy Young. He led his league in strikeouts in 2022. He led his league in whip in 2023. That's not all in 1 year. That's spread over 3 years. And his ERA, by the way, since 2020 is 2.86. for a 4-year stretch. That's an ERA plus of 1.46 with a K rate of 11. I mean, he is an ace. There's no other way to put it. And he's probably going to be very motivated to pitch well for his new team, and also maybe to set up the contract he's going to get from somebody for many years down the road. Sometimes when it gets to the walk year, those big-time players perform big time.
Yeah, and that could very well be what the difference is in him getting exactly what he wants. He has pitched very well for Milwaukee, but when you join a team that's won 101 games, that has Gunnar Henderson, that has Adley Rutschman, and is looking for that one piece that could get the Orioles over the top, Byrne represents just that. And you're not, like you said, looking too far ahead. You're really just focused on this particular year, but certainly very exciting. We look forward to talking a little bit more with Eve Rosenbaum, the Orioles assistant GM, about it. Meantime, the Orioles, a couple of moves to their 40-man roster. It's full now. Levon Soto joins the team today. He got claimed off waivers. Nick Maton, he ends up joining the team on Wednesday. So the Orioles roster isn't 40 men, Steve, but there's always the opportunity to maybe add somebody else. Last year it was a Danny Coulomb who proved to be a big part of the Orioles team. He got added right before the regular season started. So I don't necessarily think that the Orioles could be done. Maybe you get some other piece that you want to use to complement this team.
Well, the 40, you can make changes daily to that. So what's on the 40-man today? It's not a lifetime membership, by the way. And so a guy like Soto, this particular acquisition, this is a guy multiple top 30 in his career, top 30 prospect list with the Angels, signed for $1 million out of Venezuela as an international amateur, and he has two options, and he's an outstanding defender, and they just traded Joey Ortiz. So I think there's going to be an opening for some middle infielders at AAA to put behind those pitchers. You want good defense, he is that.
And you're never sure exactly who's going to be what, say, Ryan O'Hearn was to your team last year. It could be anybody. And so the Orioles trying to add along the edges of their 40-man roster. Coming up on the Orioles Hot Stove show tonight, you're going to hear from Eve Rosenbaum in just a little bit. We're going to talk about the Corbin Burnes trade and more. Then at 7:35, it's the Hall of Famer Jim Palmer who will give us a little bit of context just on what this Corbin Burnes trade means for the Orioles. We are live tonight from Mother's North in Timonium. This is Orioles Hot Stove on WBAL.
Miss a minute, miss a lot. C4 and Brian Neiman, weekdays 5:30 to 10 a.m. Expect more from WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5. WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Traffic.
In the city on Lombard Street, there is a crash at MLK Jr. Boulevard. Also in the city on Haven Street, you're going to find an accident just south of Eastern Avenue. Onto the Beltway, Inner Loop in Lockhearn, you're going to find a crash just before Liberty Road. Traffic is jammed from Baltimore National Pike. In Towson, on the Inner Loop of the Beltway, it's slow from Charles Street to Lockraven Boulevard. Now, on the Outer Loop of the Beltway in Towson, accident has been moved to the left shoulder at the Harrisburg Expressway, but the traffic is still jammed up from York Road. On 83, from Cockeysville to the city, you're not tapping the brakes. Nothing's slowing you down there. It's clear at both tunnels, the Harbor Tunnel and the Fort McHenry. And on 97 from the city to Annapolis, you're not hitting the brakes on the northbound side or on the southbound side. I'm Abby D, WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Berenberg Eye Associates is now offering dropless cataract surgery. With this procedure, you can forget about the need for eye drops in the days and weeks following your surgery. Drops can sting, be expensive, and may not be fully covered by your insurance. We have 5 convenient locations serving the greater Baltimore area for 100 years. To schedule a cataract evaluation, call 443-530-3500. That's 443-530-3500, or visit our website at berenbergeye.com. Berenberg Eye Associates, vision for life.
Proper Number 12's Triple Distilled Irish Whiskey is an ultra-smooth blend of golden grain and single malt with hints of vanilla, honey, and toasted wood for a rich complexity. Proper 12 pays homage to our founder, Conor McGregor's hometown of Crumlin, Dublin, and their shared spirit of brotherhood, loyalty, and hard work. Enjoy as a proper iced coffee teeny, an old-fashioned, or a proper palmer. Proper Number 12 Irish Whiskey is a proud supporter of the WBAL Radio Orioles Hot Stove Show. Ask your bartender or nearest liquor store if they have Proper Number 12's Triple Distilled Irish Whiskey. Live proper. Must be 21 years or older. Please Please drink responsibly.
The Orioles Hot Stove Show continues live from Mother's Grill in Timonium. This is your home for Birds Baseball. WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
It is another night at Mother's North in Timonium for the Orioles Hot Stove Show, which is presented by PBI Office Furniture and Proper 12 Irish Whiskey. Jeff Arnold, Steve Molesky tonight, sitting in for Brett Hollander, and Ribeye Reese Levin with you. And we're really pleased to be joined by Eve Rosenbaum, Orioles Assistant General Manager. Eve, it's been a really exciting last week in Birdland, and we get off the air last Thursday, 8:30 or so, and Corbin Burns' news breaks that he had been traded to the Orioles. I know what kind of the reaction was, Eve, from everyone who is still here at Mother's North, but where you were in the warehouse, what was everybody feeling once that trade went through?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry I couldn't join you guys last week because of that. But
we
I
let it go.
Good
it's
for all of us.
You had a lot going on.
Yeah. It's good for everyone in Birdland. Man, I wish I'd been a Mother's to see the reaction live. That would have been awesome. But by the time the tree actually went through, it was just me and Mike and maybe a couple other people in the warehouse. So, I mean, honestly, at that point for us, it's just, okay, like we just have to finish up the paperwork and announce it. We had our celebrations a bit earlier in the day. But definitely like everyone's super pumped in the office and off in the city. I've never really seen it buzzing like this about a move. So we're all super excited about it.
Eve, it's Steve Molesky. Glad to talk to you tonight. What was the great patience that the Oriole front office had to show like, and for you inside the warehouse the last few months, you're rumored to be going after this guy, you're rumored to be going after that guy, and yet the day-to-day kind of waiting it to play out, what was it like for you and the staff?
Yeah, patience, you hit the nail on the head. Baseball, being a baseball executive requires sort of like an unparalleled amount of patience. Part of it is because when you sign an international player when they're 16, you might not find out how good they are until they're 24. So you have to have a lot of patience to find out if you made a good decision. For something like a trade, so often what happens in these trades is you talk to teams for months and you send them a message, they text you back, you get with your group, you huddle up, you craft a response, you send the text message back, they read it, they get back to you 2 days later, and it just goes on and on and on like this. You try so many different ideas and so many different angles. And so at various points, you know, over the past couple of months, we thought the deal's alive, the deal's dead, the deal's alive, the deal's dead. And then finally we were able to get it across the finish line. So you have to be in for the long haul when you're working on trades.
We are with Eve Rosenbaum, Orioles Assistant General Manager here on Orioles Hot Stove. So you get Corbin Burns. You have a great starting rotation right now, Eve, and you've added two more guys, so your 40-man roster is full. Is it possible, though, we could see some more activity from the Orioles maybe before spring training gets underway?
Yeah, it's definitely possible. Last night we traded for Maton for cash considerations. Today we made a waiver claim. We're still trying everything we possibly can, you know, to make the team better. Even if it seems like we're just making the team better on the margins, we're still working on it every day from, you know, now until opening day.
Are those moves the last 2 days, Eve, designed for what purpose? Is it depth? Is it looking to line up some utility or super utility candidates? Is it just guys who you as an organization like and here was your chance to get them? Or maybe it was all of the above?
It is all of the above. You can never have too much depth. That's definitely something that, you know, you appreciate the longer you're in baseball. And with these particular guys, yesterday with Maton, having a left-handed second baseman is something we were interested in. The past few years, we had Odor, we had Frazier. And I know from the outside, it doesn't necessarily make sense how those guys fit our team. But for us, we like having that left-handed second baseman. It's a very specific role that they can fill with us. We didn't want to, go out and get another huge player like that. So then when Maton came along and he can fill that niche for us and he can play a few other roles as well, that just seemed perfect. And then with Soto today, with the waiver claim, he's a really good glove. He's a really good defender. And again, you can never have too much depth when you're getting a good shortstop defender. So we went ahead and snagged him for that.
Spending a few more minutes with Eve Rosenbaum, Orioles assistant general manager. The Corbin Burns news, Eve, was one of the big pieces of news last week, but there was another one, and that's that the Orioles had been sold to the Carlyle Group, David Rubenstein and his group kind of leading everything. And naturally, Twitter goes pretty wild, or X goes pretty wild, when news like this comes about. And, you know, maybe there's some uncertainty, and maybe some people have some additional questions or thoughts. But, you know, for what occurred last week on that front, what does it mean for baseball operations in the short term? And what does it maybe mean in the long term?
Yeah, yeah. First of all, did Brett tell you that he and I were at the same show when that news broke? We both ended up just like Quinn Stanley at the live taping of a podcast. We were both there, like right next to each other.
Oh, you know what? He actually did last week. Was the Bill Simmons podcast?
Yeah, exactly. We both happened to drive down to DC the same night, go to the same show while this news was breaking. So it was kind of funny timing, but, yeah, no, obviously a huge week for the Orioles last week. As far as I understand it, the whole sale process is still happening. You know, still going through the various approvals and everything that Major League Baseball has in place. So there's not really much I can, you know, say about it at this point, except I can tell you that I've really enjoyed working with John and the whole Angelus Partnership Group. And I'm excited to see what the ownership change brings for us. I think it's only good news in Birdland right now.
Eve, what makes Mike Elias so good? You've been with him for two organizations now, two winning organizations, and obviously it's so much more than one man, yourself and Sig and Matt Blood, Anthony Vila. We could go on and on. Some of the great coaches on the farm I get to cover and work with each year. But Mike came in first, and man, he has put together something that's now very special. What are some of the ways he did it?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And I could go on and on about this. I know we don't have all night. So I'll try to give a concise answer. Part of it is having really good people around you. And so when he's hired me and everyone else in the front office, and then the same thing with hiring Hyde and the whole coaching staff and even the players, you know, we want smart people. We want people who are pragmatic. We want people who aren't afraid to challenge the status quo, but we also want people who are going to get along and put the team first. And so he really prioritizes that in every personnel decision that he makes. And I think that's a huge aspect. And then in terms of the decision-making, he's very thorough. He's very pragmatic and dispassionate, just wants to gather all of the information. He wants everyone to weigh in. He wants to look at the numbers. He wants to talk to scouts. He wants to watch video. He wants to watch the players in person. And just when you have all of that information and all of these people who you trust around you, I think it's going to lead to making good decisions more often than you make the wrong decision.
Eve, one last question for me, and you hear a lot about this on the players' side when it comes to arbitration, which is a process that's going on right now. It's, for them, not a really fun process, but what is it like from the front office's perspective when you have to go into one of these meetings rooms with one of these players and you have to basically present a case which says, this is why this person is not worth this? What is it like for you all, and how do you strike that balance, realizing that these guys are still people too?
Yeah, we spend a lot of time talking about how to strike that balance. We have a whole team that works on arbitration. Brendan Forney is really the mastermind behind it, who has the most experience in this area. And he's been to a lot of cases, and he knows, you know, the type of things that can rub the players the wrong way and types of things that, you know, the players will understand in terms of, this is just business. And we're very upfront with the agents and the players of, this is just business. We don't, hopefully this doesn't end in a trial. If it does, you know, we still really value the player. We want him to be a part of our team, and we hope there's no hard feelings. And almost always the player and the agent respond back to us and they say, you know, we love it here. We understand this is just a part of how the game is played. It's just a part of the system. It's the system that we have. And they understand it's just business, and there's usually no hard feelings after it.
Well, Eve, we know that we've got a week before pitchers and catchers report. It's going to be really fun, and I'm sure we're going to have a chance to catch up with you a lot more when we're down in Sarasota. But thanks for taking some time with us tonight.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Sorry I couldn't cancel on you again tonight for another huge trade.
You know what? We have forgiven you for that. But next time, if you have any news that you want to break and you want to do it yourself on the show, we're more than welcome to that.
Yeah, that would have been funny. Yeah, that would have been good. But yeah, I'll see you guys down in Sarasota soon. Thanks for having me on.
That is Orioles Assistant General Manager Eve Rosenbaum. We're going to take a break. Come back with more of Orioles Hot Stove in just a moment on WBAL.
Weekdays from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Continue the conversation with T.J. Smith. Expect more from WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Lancaster County, Pennsylvania is a wonderful blend of rural splendor and urban style with many rich cultures from the Amish to the arts. It's just a short drive to our wide open countryside, so come make some great memories. Lancaster features a hip downtown, wonderful family attractions, a varied culinary and drink scene, numerous recreational activities, walkable small towns, great shopping, and loads of lodging options. So start planning your Lancaster road trip today at discoverlancaster.com.
Growing up in the 60s and 70s was a simpler time. We had rec ball, school activities, and a man's bathing suit consisted of a pair of old cutoff jeans. Hi, this is Dan McLaughlin from Baby Home Care. There's nothing more gratifying than going back into our old neighborhood and taking care of those who took care of us growing up. Most seniors prefer to stay at home as long as they can, and the home medical equipment we provide allows them to do so. Visit babyhomecare.com for more info, and thank you to all the parents, teachers, and coaches who touched our lives.
It's time for an encore in 2024 with the Orioles and Superbook Sports. And now is the time to place your bets ahead of the baseball season with the official sports betting partner of the Baltimore Orioles. If you sign up, wager, and deposit on the Superbook Sports app or superbook.com today, you can earn a $250 bonus. So win some dough on the O's this season with the Orioles and Superbook Sports.
Visit superbook.com for terms and conditions. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Bring Natalia Squire, Slater, Slater, Schulman, LLP. Attorney Advertising is responsible for this ad.
Attention, former childhood residents of juvenile detention centers in Maryland. If you were housed at either Charles Hickey School, Backbone Mountain Youth Center, Thomas Waxter Detention Center, Cheltenham Youth Detention Center, or any other juvenile detention center at any time in the past and were a victim of sexual abuse, now is the time to come forward, as you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Maryland Department of Juvenile Services faced complaints about rampant sexual abuse for decades and failed to protect youth inmates in these facilities. If you were housed in a Maryland youth facility at any time and were subjected to any sexual misconduct from staff members, you may be entitled to substantial cash compensation. Call our Maryland Juvenile Detention Helpline now at 800-480-9017. The deadline to file a claim is close. Call now to get the justice, closure, and the financial settlement you deserve. No matter how many decades ago it was, call our law firm's Juvenile Detention Sexual Abuse Helpline right now at 800-480-9017. 800-480-9017. 800-480-9017. 800-480-9017.
Hey, Birdland, 2024 single game tickets are on sale now. Tickets start as low as $12. Don't miss the action at Camden Yards this summer. Buy your tickets now at Orioles.com/tickets.
That is the voice of Steve Molesky, Jeff Arnold, and Ribeye Reese Levin with you. Orioles Hot Stove Show and Mother's North in Timonium. Again, we've got a good crowd of Orioles fans who are out here today, some regulars and some new faces as well, and what will be our final show here at Mother's North. We've got two shows of our Hot Stove season left before we head down to Sarasota for some baseball there. The Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer, he is going to join us next, and he's going to go into this Corbin Burns deal as well, his level of excitement about it, as well as maybe what the historical context is and just how big of a trade this is when you look back at all the trades the Orioles have done over the years.
Well, he's been in a few good Oriole rotations through the years, and he's watched a few. So who better to get a historical context of Oriole starting rotations than number 22?
I mean, it is going to be fun to talk to him. And then later on, we're going to talk a little bit more about this rotation, which figures to stack up as one of the best groups in all of baseball. We are live from Mother's North in Timonium. We're going to take a break for the news. Come back with the Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer, in just a moment on WBAL.
WBAL WIYY HD2 Baltimore.
All day, every day. News, weather, traffic.
Plus insight and analysis. Expect more.
WBAL News Radio 1090.
FM 101.5. And the WBAL Radio app.
An accusation of domestic assault facing a Baltimore Ravens wide receiver, plus a school bus rollover in one part of Howard County. We'll tell you how the students that were hurt are doing. But first, the latest from ABC News. It's 7:30.
ABC News, I'm Daria Albinger, Capitol Hill. Republicans reacting to a special counsel report on President Biden's handling of classified documents. ABC's Jay O'Brien.
95% of the reaction we've been getting from congressional Republicans at this hour has very little to do with the law or the legal questions in this report. All of the reaction, or practically all of it we've seen from Republicans right now, is talking about these issues of the president's memory.
Special counsel Robert Hur is not recommending criminal charges, but his report does criticize Mr. Biden and his associates, and it takes issue with Mr. Biden's memory during their interview. The Supreme Court appears poised to reject an attempt by Colorado to ban former President Trump from the ballot after hearing arguments today. ABC News can project Mr. Trump will win the Virgin Islands Republican caucus. Virginia's House of Delegates votes down a bill that would have resulted in a nearly total ban on abortions. This is ABC News.
WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5 News Update.
48 degrees here on TV Hill at 7:32. I'm Phil Yakubuski. Now the latest from the WBAL 24-hour broadcast center. A school bus rollover along Old Columbia Road in Howard County this afternoon. Four students rushed to the hospital. Others were treated at the scene. So far, no indication that the injuries are life-threatening. We're told the bus driver is okay. Baltimore Ravens wide receiver Zay Flowers facing accusations of domestic assault. TV 11 News says the Ravens also releasing a statement today saying, "We are aware of the report regarding Zay Flowers, and we take these matters seriously. We'll have no further comment." In our Commitment 2024 report, City Council President Nick Mosby has filed for re-election one day before the due date. During the testimony in his ex-wife's mortgage fraud trial, where she was found guilty on two counts, he told the jury it was all his fault that he let the past due tax and mortgage notices pile up with the rest of the mail as he mismanaged their finances for nearly a decade. In Annapolis, a bill drafted following the murder of a Western Maryland judge has passed the Senate. The bill bans the publishing of the addresses and other personal information of current or retired judges and their families. Violators would face up to $5,000 in fines. The bill drafted after that October killing of a Washington County judge in his driveway by a man who the judge ruled against in a custody dispute. Hot Stove Baseball continues live from Mother's North in Timonium at 7:33. I'm Phil Yakubuski on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Valentine's Day is here. This year, give the ultimate gift. Name a star after your sweetheart. This is Rocky Moselle with International Star Registry. For 45 years, we've named millions of stars for celebrities, dignitaries, and individuals worldwide. For $59 and a call to 800-282-3333 or visit starregistry.com, you can give the most memorable gift. The star you name will be recorded in book form in the U.S. Copyright Office. Visit starregistry.com or call 800-282-3333.
Visit PVI Office Furniture today. PVI is more than just office furniture. You can find desks, chairs, tables, systems, bookcases, filing cabinets, toaster ovens, and even refrigerators, sofas, and orange chairs too. Shop new and used for your office space. It's your one-stop shop and well worth the drive. Visit their showroom on Monroe Avenue in Frederick, Maryland. At PVI, you can expect first-class service that's fast, affordable, and customer-focused. Pickup or delivery available. Visit PVI.com. That's PVI.com. Business grows with PVI.
At MedStar Health, we know anything can happen at any time. And with easy access to the same high-quality care that the Orioles trust, you're always ready for what if. Like, what if you have the grand slam of headaches? Or what if an injury keeps throwing you curveballs? We'll be there with easy ways to get the care you need, like 24/7 telehealth and the region's largest network of urgent care. MedStar Health. It's how we treat people.
WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Traffic.
This report is sponsored by Whole Foods Market. On the inner loop of the Beltway in Lockhearn, there is an accident just before Liberty Road. Traffic is jammed up from Baltimore National Pike. Outer loop of the Beltway in Towson, accident has been moved to the left shoulder before the Harrisburg Expressway, but the traffic is slow from Charles Street. On 83, from Cockeysville to the city, you're not hitting the brakes north or south. At the tunnels, no delays at the Harbor Tunnel or the Fort McHenry. 97 from the city to Annapolis. You're at the posted speed limit on the northbound side and on the southbound side. The love affair is on at Whole Foods Market, with sizzling sales on animal welfare certified New York strip steaks, sustainable wild caught lobster tails, and more through Valentine's Day. Find deals on all your delicious desires at Whole Foods Market. I'm Albie D, WBAL News Radio, 1090 and FM 101.5.
WBAL TV 11, weather.
Partly cloudy skies tonight with low temperatures ranging from 32 to 39. It'll be partly cloudy and mild on Friday with highs around 60. On Saturday, partly to mostly cloudy, mild temperatures, a chance for a shower toward evening, highs in the low 60s. I'm meteorologist Tom Tasselmeyer on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Now, more of the Orioles Hot Stove Show, keeping you informed on all the latest news on the birds. We are live from Mother's Grill and Timonium, WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
And we welcome you back to Timonium and Mother's Grill. Thanks to all the great Orioles fans who are here once again. Jeff Arnold, Massinsport.com, Steve Molesky, and Ribeye Reese Levin with you. And we're going to go back to the phone, but first we'll tell you that the Orioles Hot Stove Show presented by PVI Office Furniture and Jose Cuervo Tradicional Tequila. And the person we're going to, the Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer, spending a little bit of time with us on this Thursday. Jim, how are you tonight?
Quite well. And you guys?
Doing great. Brett's deciding to be a little bit lazy tonight, so Steve's been fortunate enough that he's going to fill in for him. And yeah, but we're doing well. One last live show here. Ribeye's a little bit bummed. He's not going to get any free food anymore on Thursdays.
Yeah, well, you know, I know that if he'd be there, if you're at a restaurant, that you're at Mother's. So, and of course, Steve's getting ready for all the streaming he's going to do in spring training.
Exactly.
Jim, let's start with the big news. Corbin Burns, Orioles trade for him. You get the ace pitcher. I know what the reaction was like from us when we were at Mother's last Thursday, but when you heard the news that Corbin Burns was going to be an Oriole, what was your reaction?
Well, you get this is considering he stays healthy and he pitches the way he's pitched. I mean, you know, he won the Cy Young, and as you guys know, in 2021, I mean, he's a guy that strikes out about a batter per inning or more, low ERA. Can, you know, as he did last year and the year before, give you about 192 to 200 innings. Potential, again, if he stays healthy, number one starter. And I think, you know, when you start looking at the rest of the Orioles rotation, first of all, I mean, you lose Kyle Gibson. You know, Kyle, he did exactly what they wanted him to do. Came in, won a bunch of games, led the team with 15 wins. They played really well behind him, scored over 6 runs a game. You know, the ERA probably had 6 bad games that got his ERA up into the high 4s. But other than that, 32 starts, 26 of those games, he gave you, you know, games where you had a chance to win. Now, the difference between Kyle and Corbin Burns is that, you know, Kyle, what, turned 36, Corbin's 29. It's most likely, unless the Orioles open up the pocketbook, it's going to be a one-year deal. But this is also somebody that if you do get to the playoffs, something the Orioles did, as we all know, last year with 101 wins, winning the American League East, you have somebody that can match up in the playoffs. And along with Kyle Bradish, if Kyle's able to pitch the way he did last year, you have two number one starters.
I mean, it is an incredible rotation, one of the best in baseball now that you have Corbin Burns. You know, I was thinking about this, Jim, and you've been obviously with this organization for a really long time. You know, historical context for you of the trade for Corbin Burns. Where does this one rank in Orioles history?
Well, you know, it's funny. I mean, when I got to the Orioles, we had Milt Pappas. He was arguably our best starter, maybe a little bit better than Dave McNally, who would go on to win 20 games 4 times for us. But we traded him for Frank Robinson. You know, Frank came over, won the Triple Crown, hit 49 home runs, 2 in the World Series. But I think the other trade, and I think it's probably, unless you really look at the numbers, was the trade for Mike Cuellar in the winter of 1968. Mike would come over and in 7 years won 147 games. And if you do the math, one Cy Young should have won two. But the difference is, you know, he stayed for those 7 years. Marvelous left-handed pitcher, could pitch with 2 days rest. We used to pitch every fourth day, so we had 3 days rest. If Earl Weaver needed him late in the year, he'd pitch with 2 days rest and be effective. So again, I don't know if he had the credential that Corbin has, but the Orioles got, you know, I mean, the Yankees signed Stroman, you know, the Red Sox signed Giolito, who went 8-15 with 41 home runs thrown, gave him $38.5 million. So they're hoping he makes a comeback. But if you look at in the American League East, the team that made the best acquisition, I mean, Stroman, you know, he was an all-star the first half, got hurt the second half. But Corbin Burns, free agent year, you would think that would feel even be better than he's capable of. Hopefully he won't overthrow, because I think if you go back and look at his career, came up, had a little bit of success, then really struggled trying to, you know, power everybody, and then decided that I think what all good pitching starting pitchers learn is you don't have to throw every pitch max effort, 95% when you have great stuff and you have a great cutter like he does, great curveball, you don't get a lot of hitters out.
And Jim, a long line in Oriole history of veteran guys helping the young guys. And we even saw it in recent years, what Lyles did, what Gibson did. And so Burns has said he's up for that, kind of a mentor role. And what can it mean to the younger pitchers on this staff in both watching how this guy goes about his business and, two, him helping them?
Well, I think the first thing is, you know, it's you're pitching on Tuesday and he pitches on Monday, you pay attention. And, you know, you got to understand that other than John Means, who hopefully will recover, come back. I mean, he pitched well at the end of last year after recovering, but almost 2 years from the Tommy John. He's the only left-hander that you're going to have in your starting staff. So you got Bradish, who had a terrific year. If they'd gotten him as many runs as they did most of the Oriole pitchers, he would have won a lot more than, 12 games. You know what he gave up? Pitched six innings in 12 of his last 13 starts. I think, you know, Grayson Rodriguez went, 5-2. Pitched really well in July, didn't get a lot of run support, didn't get any wins. And then the last 2 months went 5-2 with low ERAs, you know, in the low twos. You know, did struggle in the playoffs, first time he ever experienced that. But my experience was, if you're pitching on Wednesday and you know that the guy on Monday and Tuesday and then the guy behind you, and now in this case with a five-man rotation Friday, is capable of pitching well in the Orioles, as you mentioned, have a lot of depth. You have Wells, you have Kramer. I think Dean Kramer has as good a stuff as anybody, maybe not a slider like, you know, Bradish has or whatever, but he's capable of pitching better than he did last year. And on occasion, you know, maybe the last, 2-3 months, he really pitched well, did not have a good playoffs. He had just had the attack in Israel. Can't imagine what that's like when you have friends and family over there and all of a sudden you have to go get the best American League team, offensive team out, which were the Texas Rangers, who would go on to win the World Series. But, you know, other, you know, starters look, because of the Burns trade, because he takes Gibson's place and maybe a little bit better quality pitcher. I think the biggest problem is, okay, what's the bullpen going to look with Felix Bautista? Most likely going to miss all of this year, and hopefully he'll be back, in 2025.
Wrapping up with the Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer. You know, Jim, we know that adding Corbin Burns helps out the bullpen too, because you talked about Tyler Wells and how it's likely he's going to slide into that pen and help the team out in some way, shape, or form. Would you still like to see the Orioles maybe get another reliever to help that unit out even more?
Well, I think maybe you would like to replace D.L. Hall. You know, I mean, a big fan of DL. He's got great stuff. You know, if you look back at his minor league career, it was always, you know, whether it was the elbow, whether it was the back last year. So he never pitched a lot of innings, but very impressive. So, you know, Danny Coulomb came over from Minnesota and had a great year. So maybe you'd like to have another lefty in the bullpen to maybe match up. And we all know this is a bullpen game. I'm looking at Corbin Burns, and it's not that he's not a really good pitcher, because he is, but he doesn't pitch a lot of complete games and shutouts. So you need to, especially, you know, the Orioles, I mean, what they did so well last year, they were great. You know, they were, 30-16 in one-run games, so they know what that is like. They were 11-6 in extra inning games, which means you better have somebody that can strike people out. Felix Bautista could do that. You know, they only Cincinnati came from behind more than they did in winning ball games. So again, you know, and the other thing they did offensively, they went from about a little bit over 4 runs a game in 2022 when they won 83 games to almost scoring 5 runs a game last year. Not as many at home because of the configuration of Camden Yards, but they almost scored 5.8 runs a game on the road. You know, when you start looking at what they were able to do, you know, they actually had a better road record. ERA was a little bit higher, but the runs scored. And the other thing I look at, guys, is, you know, they went from when they, only won 52 games back in 2021, they were outscored by 297 runs. Last year, they outscored the opposition by almost 130. So a big, big difference. We all know they have a lot of great young players, and hopefully these guys will even get better. I look at this team and I'm going, well, what if Mountcastle doesn't have vertigo? And what if Mullins doesn't pull a hip flexor or a quad, whatever you want to call it? You know, he was hitting like 400 when he got hurt the end of July or end of, of May, trying to beat out that infield hit against Cleveland. So, you know, again, they have guys that actually could be better. I mean, don't you got to think that the rookie of the year, Gunnar Henderson, will be more like he was the last 4 months than the first 2 months when he was hitting about 199. So, again, I look at this club. They take away the 101 wins. It's the American League East may be a little bit better with the Yankees getting Stroman and Soto and, you know, Trent Grisham and all those kind of and making those kind of moves. But at the end of the day, the Orioles have a chance to still win this division. And I think now one of the things is you got to figure out how to do that. And they learned the formula last year.
They certainly have a lot of weapons this year, too. Jim, thanks so much for doing this. And the first bottle of Pinot Noir down in Sarasota is on me.
Yeah, well, I got to get there first. We're doing the spring training games from Baltimore. So, maybe you're not, but I am. Just in case, I'm going to try to get down there for 4 or 5 days. If not, just send it to the warehouse on February 24th when we do the first spring training game in Baltimore. But I'm looking forward to seeing you guys, and I hope you have a great spring.
Jim, thanks for
and
the
I
time.
Hope the Orioles have a great spring.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Jim, thanks so much for the time. That's the Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer. More of Orioles Hot Stove Show coming up in just a moment on WBAL.
Ride home and react to the day's top stories. Tori Snow, weekday afternoons from 2 to 6 p.m. WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Planning a move? Call Von Paris Moving and Storage, the official mover of the Orioles. Whether it's a move across the street or around the world, or an office or a commercial move, you can trust the Von Paris team to get things done safely, on time, and on budget. Von Paris has an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau and was the recipient of the BBB's Pillars of Trust Award. For Marketplace Trust, Von Paris, since 1892, always going the extra mile for you. Contact Von Paris at vonparis.com.
If you have an appetite for saving money, then you should get the ROFO Rewards app from Royal Farms. Use the ROFO Rewards app to place mobile orders for pickup or delivery and earn royalty points to redeem for free stuff. And right now, new ROFO Rewards members will get a free any size coffee for signing up. You can download the ROFO Rewards app at the Apple App Store or Google Play today. You'll find it's a very app-ealing app to have. Real fresh, real fast, Royal Farms.
CFG Bank is not your typical bank. As Baltimore's bank, CFG Bank is bold, entrepreneurial, and not afraid to think outside of the box to create solutions. With big bank capabilities and a boutique bank care, CFG Bank is transforming the banking experience to help you reach your personal and business goals. Partner with CFG Bank, Baltimore's bank. Visit cfg.bank to get started. Member FDIC.
Winter may sound like a strange time to replace the windows in your home, but with Window Nation, it's the perfect time. Right now, Window Nation is offering you 50% off all window styles. Plus, you could get 0% interest for 5 years. Get rid of those cold, drafty windows that are costing you money to heat your home. With savings this big, it's time to give Window Nation a look. It's easy. Simply call 866-90-NATION or visit windownation.com. That's 866-90-NATION or windownation.com.
The Orioles Hot Stove Show, WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Hey, Birdland, you can cheer on the Orioles with a 2024 Birdland membership. Buy now and receive the members-only Gunnar Henderson 2023 Rookie of the Year bobblehead. Secure your Birdland membership at Orioles.com/membership.
That is Steve Molesky, Jeff Arnold with you, along with Ribeye Reese Levin, the Orioles Hot Stove Show, presented by PBI Office Furniture and Proper 12 Iris Whiskey. A special thanks to the Hall of Famer, Jim Palmer, and Orioles Assistant General Manager, Eve Rosenbaum, for joining us tonight. And we go back to the rotation, Steve. Burns, Bradish, Grayson, Means, Kramer. I mean, that is a murderer's row. You actually had a piece about it today in MassinSports.com. And when you stack up that rotation, it very well could be the best in the American League, and it is certainly one of the top two or three best in all of baseball.
They were talking about it on MLB Network earlier this week, Jeff, and they basically listed, and it didn't rank them, but they said the best rotations, in their opinion, on that show, in some order, were Seattle, Baltimore, Yankees, Houston, Toronto. I look at these five, the way they're stacked up, and to me, Toronto, that's formidable because Alec Manoah, I think, is going to come back and be good, and he's slotted towards the end right now with them, with Gausman, Barrios, Bassett, Kikuchi. Yankees could be formidable. Stroman is a little bit of a wild card, and how will the, you know, will Rodon and Cortez get back to their previous form? If yes, that's big for the Yankees. But again, now you have the Orioles, and just look at the second half. To me, they were third in the American League in rotation ERA after the All-Star break before they got Corbin Burns. And all these young kids like Grayson and Bradish were really coming on strong late.
And I think the other thing that you love about this younger group of Orioles pitchers is the fact that this year you can finally just let them go. You know, Bradish threw almost 170 innings last year. Kramer reached 172 innings. And you have to remember both those guys pitched in the playoffs. Grayson Rodriguez over 160 between the major leagues and also AAA. So if you add all those things up, you add Corbin Burns to the mix, that should take a bunch of pressure off your bullpen in a year where without Felix Bautista, you're going to need that.
It's a great point, the innings, because last year they had to go to a six-man. They felt it was really beneficial for their rotation. But now if Kramer is the fifth and you bump Tyler Wells to the bullpen, that's quite a bullpen arm. Cole Irvin could be a long man out of that bullpen. I think the Orioles are excited about guys like Chase McDermott and Cade Povich. Seth Johnson came back at the end of last year. So they're really building some depth. And there are a couple, and I'll be writing more about this in the next week or two, young international pitchers who are going to be AA or above this year, who are getting close. We're getting close to that time when one of these young international pitchers is going to impact AAA and the major leagues.
And we know that it takes a long time to get there. If you're an international player and you get signed at 16 years old, you're spending time in the Dominican at the Orioles New Academy, and then you gradually work your way up from the very bottom rung of the minor league ladder till you're a spot like Samuel Basayo, AA player who got to the Bowie Bay Sox last year. He's knocking on the door. And the other great thing about that Burns deal, the Orioles farm system is deep, and it still remains the best in all of baseball because it hurts to lose D.L. Hall and Joey Ortiz, but you still have your top five prospects overall.
How good is that farm? It's so good that J.J. Cooper, Baseball America, said after they traded Ortiz and Hall, there is still a big gap from Baltimore to whoever's number two, however you rank number two. So that is the definition of an elite talent pipeline, and that is how you use an elite talent pipeline. You bring players like Gunnar and Adley to help you. You trade some players to help you as well. So the two big ways the farm works is they come and they help you win, or they come or you trade them for someone who comes to also help you win.
And the thing about D.L. Hall is great pitcher, really good out of the bullpen. I was impressed with him in particular in the postseason, how he picks against the Texas Rangers. But just trying to find a rotation spot with the group that you have in right now, going to Milwaukee is going to give him a chance to be a starting pitcher, which is really, I think, what he wants to do.
You know, a lot of people have pointed out these trades, prospect for help now, 5 years from now, there might be more war of those two players in Milwaukee than Corbin Burns generates in 1 year in Baltimore. But this was, you know, flip the script. Remember the Mancini trade, they're bringing in prospects. The Jorge Lopez trade, they're bringing in prospects. Now the Orioles, the shoe is on the other foot. They're trading prospects for big-time help. They got an ace pitcher. They have 101 wins. They still have the number one farm. They have a great fan base with an amazing stadium. So I think things are okay in Birdland right now.
Yeah, I think things are going pretty well for the Orioles coming off that 101 win year. And I've done this for a while, and so have you. I mean, the anticipation is palpable. Like, I was excited for last year, but this year just has a little something extra. You don't feel like this going into regular seasons too often.
It's exciting to see. I mean, the Orioles, when John Means starts this year, could put out a first division lineup of all homegrown players. Go around the diamond, and everybody they put out there could be an original Oriole draft pick. And in a year or two, some international guys are going to start filtering in.
And that's extraordinarily rare. But it's a system that's unique. It's a major league team. It's one of the best in baseball. We are live here at Mother's North in Timonium. We're going to take one last break, come back, and wrap things up. Listen to Orioles Hot Stove on WBAL.
The news never stops in Baltimore, and neither do we. Covering the community like none other. Expect more. WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Visit PVI Office Furniture today. PVI is more than just office furniture. You can find desks, chairs, tables, systems, bookcases, filing cabinets, toaster ovens, and even refrigerators. Sofas and orange chairs, too. Shop new and used for your office space. It's your one-stop shop and well worth the drive. Visit their showroom on Monroe Avenue in Frederick, Maryland. At PVI, you can expect first-class service that's fast, affordable, and customer-focused. Pickup or delivery available. Visit PVIPVI.com. That's PVIPVI.com. Business grows with PVI.
Jose Cuervo Tradicional is aged 100% blue agave. Enjoy the essence of agave and herbaceous notes and oak notes, including vanilla, caramel, and toast. It goes down smooth with lingering notes of vanilla, clove, cinnamon, and toffee. Available as an Añejo or Reposado, its versatility elevates a Manhattan, Paloma, Margarita, or even a Mexican hot chocolate. Jose Cuervo Tradicional is a proud supporter of the WBAL Radio Orioles Hot Stove Show. Ask your bartender or nearest liquor store if they have Jose Cuervo Tradicional. Must be 21 years or older. Please drink responsibly.
Fans, become part of the Orioles Insider. Receive exclusive news, highlights, ticket offers, and more, all delivered free to your inbox wherever you are. Visit Orioles.com/newsletter to join today.
Steve Molesky, Jeff Arnold, Ribeye Reese Levin with you. I'm really sad to say this because I've had so much fun since we got Hot Stove season kicked off, Steve. But this is the last show that we are going to do on location. So a special thanks to all the fans who have shown up week in and week out. Give yourselves a round of applause. It is so great to see you. And I know you feel this way too, but to interact with Orioles fans in the offseason, especially in an offseason that includes getting Corbin Burns, you get Craig Kimbrell. I mean, you can't really beat it. You know, it brings your excitement level up.
It does. The fan base is jacked up, and that's great to see. And, I mean, during the Birdland Caravan, going around different places and some of the happy hours they had, it was at the one in Harford County, Baltimore City, just awesome.
Really is. We have got to go. Thanks again, Orioles Hot Stove Show here at Mother's North in Timonium. Check out the next 2 weeks' episodes on WBAL. You can also check out the podcast as well. For Ribeye Reese and Steve Molesky, Jeff Arnold saying good night.
The president now speaking at the White House in regards to the special counsel not seeking criminal charges in relation to classified material. Here's the president.